Bakr, they curse Sahaba. Have you heard Shia cursing Fir'aun? I never heard Shia cursing Fir'aun. Have you heard the Shia cursing Abu Lahab? No. Have you heard the Shia cursing Abu Jahl? No. They don't curse. Or the wife Abu Lahab? No. Shia is a poison knife at the back of the Muslim Ummah. Shia, they have the enemies of Islam to destroy the Caliphate al-Abbasi, al-Abbasiya. It's known. Likewise in Iraq, it's known. Shia is known to be. But some of them are masakin, the layman, so we speak to them nicely. Even those who are stubborn, we speak to them. We don't have to fight. Expose them, show them that this is true. Alhamdulillah, I've been challenging Shia for the last 15 years, akhi. Show me one verse, because it's a hadith. The hadith, there's many hadiths that follow Sahaba. Don't you accept it? No. So you accept the Quran? Yes. Quran praised Sahaba clearly, Muhajir and Ansar. Quran mentioned the wives at al-Bayt. Shia, Quran is not with them. That's why they don't know Quran. That's why even their scholars, they cannot even recite Quran properly. Because the Shia are not a people of Quran. They are people of paganism, people of polytheism, people of shirk, people of ilhad. That's their reality. And some of them are, as we have mentioned, the layman being deceived. I came from a Sufi background. You understand, akhi? They were doing shirk. I didn't say, yeah, my family are doing it. No, the whole city is doing it. Let me do it. Alhamdulillah, when a brother gave me da'wah, I accepted it, alhamdulillah. Sorry, uncle, go on, sorry.
I have to ask one question.
Yeah.
The picture have been released, Lady of the Heaven.
Yeah.
Have you heard about it?
Yeah, we're just discussing it right now.
Okay.
What I've heard, someone can confirm that all the bad people are black. And all the good people are white.
Yeah.
And they try to say, because in the Shia source, there's something about black. The Shia source, the guy tried to justify by saying, historically, Abu Bakr is black. Abu Bakr is not black, historically.
But Shia Hadith in Al-Kafi also says you can't marry a black person.
Black, yeah. Yeah.
But in that one, Amma Aisha has been insulted in that film.
Huh?
Amma Aisha, Hazrat Aisha.
Uncle, Afwan, they even tried to put Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. They say he's not a human being, he's a PC, he's a computer. Regardless, Prophet Sallam will respect him. To show you, Shia have no respect for Prophet Muhammad Sallam. Wallahi, you know, if someone tell you Christian respect Jesus, do they respect? No. The true respect of Jesus is by following Islam. The true respect of Al-Bayt is by following the Sunnah. The Christians, everyone, the Christians, they say to us what? You hate Jesus. Why? Because we tell them, do not worship Jesus. The Shia, they say you hate al-Bayt. Why? Because we tell them do not worship al-Bayt. Shia and the Christians are the same. Both of them are hiding behind the most beloved people after the Prophet Muhammad to us and the Prophet and Messengers al-Bayt, because we love the Prophet and Messengers more than al-Bayt, okay? That after Prophet and Messengers, yeah, they're hiding behind that to spread their disbelief and paganism. So if you want to love Jesus correctly, if you want to love and believe in Jesus correctly, come to Ahl-Sunnah Islam. Look at Shia. Shia, they make you worship Ali. They are another human being. If you want to love Ahl Bayt correctly, become a Sunni. That's how it is.
I have one more.
Yeah.
I'm from India and Pakistan.
MashaAllah.
Recently, and I'm a Muslim.
Alhamdulillah, yeah.
My question is this, that in India, they have insulted Rasulullah Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And you can see the demonstration is going on there with the Indian people.
Yeah.
Doing their Vande Mataram, which you don't understand. I do understand what is Vande Mataram. Another thing. My question is this. Insulting Rasulullah Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what should we do?
You tell them, these guys, they believe the poo, the feces of their cow is a blessing. Have you not seen them rubbing the feces over their bodies? This one, how can they insult Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? Do you know why they insult him? Because Prophet came with purification. And they hate purification. They hate to be clean. They like to be dirty. That's why they hate Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Simple way, expose them. They love to cover themselves with poo and feces. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, this haram, clean yourself. Have a nice perfume. Use a seawack. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, these people, anyone insult Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, is like a man, as I mentioned the brothers here earlier on, is like a man who is uncomfortable with the sun because it's too heat. Too much heat for him. So what he does is spit on the sun. What happens? He lands back on his face. That's what happened to them. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, anyone that insult Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam, Allah humiliates him in history.
My last question. Sir, as you said that you can answer them. My knowledge is not that great like yourself. You are a scholar and such.
No, I'm not a scholar. No way, I'm a scholar. I'm someone that love knowledge.
Even some of them, they know better Islam than me, these Hindus and other things. I don't have the answer. Where the scholars should go and answer those people?
Ask them what? About cleaning themselves with the poo?
No,
I mean, that's common sense. That you don't have to even Muslim to understand that is disgusting. You know? Alhamdulillah, we don't worship a cow. I mean, like, come on, you worship a cow. Recently, they found a Hindu here. He was having intercourse with a cow. Yeah, well, it's a newspaper. I don't know. You know, the Arab pagans, they used to worship, they used to make idols from dates, tamar. Then when he gets angry, he eats it. These people, they were too crazy. They start having intercourse with their god. Alhamdulillah, sorry, uncle. Why they get angry? Why? Have you noticed, uncle?
Yeah,
Christians, listen to this, yeah, Christians. Not every Christian, by the way, because there's some Christians against these people and against Islam haters. Islam haters from Christians, Jews, atheists, Hindus, Sikh, you name it. Those Islam haters, they come together against Islam even though they hate each other. Even though they go against each other. Why? Do you know why? Alaykum salatu alaykum. Do you know why? Because they see Islam is a powerful deen. Even though the Muslims are weak. So why is powerful? They should reflect. They should step back and reflect. Think, hold a minute. Muslim countries are weak. That's the reality, you know? And so why this religion is so powerful that we as atheists and Christians and a Hindu and a Sikh and Christians come together to fight against it? Because it's from Allah the Almighty. And Allah mentioned that Allah will spread Islam, even if disbelievers dislike it.
Allah has created every time a Moses or a Pharaoh. My question is this, that when Allah is going to provide us Moses who could fight against America, Pharaoh?
No, we don't have Moses. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam is Allah's messenger of Allah. What we have Mujaddidun fi Deen. The scholars will come and revive the Deen. And a scholar, a Mujaddidun of the Deen, doesn't have to be only in ilm. They can be in, what they call it, in giving the victory to the Muslims again. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran. And Nabi, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam has prophesied about these people. He said, تَتَدَاعَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْأُمَمْ كَمَا تَتَدَاعَ الْأَكَلَةُ عَلَىٰ قِسْعَتِهَا. That the nations will come together against you just as the people come together to eat a meal. قالوا أمن قلة يا رسول الله. Is it because you are little? He said, no, you are lots. But what? Allah will send down. حب الهون. Is what? He said, what is الهون? He said, حب الدنيا وكراهية الموت. He said, Allah will send down humiliation. Or الهون. He said, what is الهون? He said, because you start loving the dunya and you hate death. You know? So what is happening to us now? Because ourselves, we know the disease. Prophet, you know, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, everything that is happening around the world, the messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam told us about it. But we as the Muslims, we know the cure, but we don't like this cure. Because why? We have an inferiority complex. You see, so what we do, we look for another cure, even though the other cure we're looking for is the poison and the disease. So for us to have the izzah we had before, let us go back to the Quran and the Sunnah. Let us go back to the Quran and the Sunnah. Let us go back to our deen. Let's learn our deen. Worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many Muslims, uncle, you know, they don't pray?
A lot of them, including myself.
You know the time of the Salaf, if you don't pray, you're not normal. You know now, if a Muslim say, I don't pray, you think it's adi, normal to you, yeah? Back in those days, when Islam, uncle, sorry to cut you because you're older than me, just to mention, when Islam was powerful, it was very strange Muslims don't pray. So we should not blame. I mean, why are you blaming these people? Do I have to explain to people they are enemies of Allah? Allah told us. What Allah told us is that we have to go back to the deen of Allah, to Allah give us a victory. But we are too lazy. We are busy going to watch singers, watch a football. You see Moroccan, Algerian fighting each other because of football. You see Egyptian and Kuwaiti fighting for football. They hate each other for football. They love each other because of football. How Allah is going to help us? When we have a love and hatred for this dirty ball, then how Allah is going to help us?
By accusing ourselves, do you think we can get away?
Say again, uncle?
By accusing ourselves that we don't practice and don't believe, can we get away with that argument?
Well, yes, if we...
Humiliated.
No, if we accuse our...
word is being humiliated.
Uncle, if we know the disease, because imagine someone said to you, listen, uncle, may Allah forbid, or someone, he said, imagine, or Shamsi, someone tell Shamsi, you know, akhi, your leg is not working properly. You have to go to the doctor. And I keep saying, no, 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 no. I'm not going to rectify myself. First step to rectify myself, I have to admit that I have a problem with my leg. Secondly, take the second step to go see the doctor. Firstly, we have to accept that we are in a mess. Nobody say, second step, what is it? Going back to Quran and Sunnah. We are too busy with other things. Even myself, I'm not best. I'm not perfect. I have my own mistakes. You know, I have to rectify myself, rectify my families, you know, and my wife helps me and I help them, you know. So this is the reality, you know. So we have to start with ourselves. Musa alayhi salam, uncle, you said about Musa. When Musa alayhi salam came to Fir'aun, was he busy with Fir'aun or he turned away from Fir'aun and he became busy with teaching Bani Israel? Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, when he came to Fir'aun, was he busy with Fir'aun all the time speaking to Fir'aun, or he gave the da'wah to Fir'aun, then he turned away from Fir'aun and he started teaching Bani Israel? He started teaching Bani Israel. That's what the Quran says us.
He gave the da'wah to
Fir'aun. Fir'aun doesn't want to listen. Khalas? Fir'aun doesn't want to listen. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he didn't start saying, Fir'aun, he was wearing trousers today. Fir'aun, he was not wearing trousers today. Muslims now, we are too busy speaking about the Muslim leaders, yeah? But us, we are in a mess too. You understand? Some people say the reason we are in a mess because of Muslim leaders, okay, there's a Muslims here, mashallah, you see young brothers here practicing Islam. They're in the country when haram is everywhere. But they choose to practice Islam. So don't blame them. Yes, they still have haram. They have to ask Allah, they have to answer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They're in a big mess too. May Allah guide us and guide them, no doubt about that. But you cannot say, I'm doing haram because the leader is allowing it. When you have a Muslims in Britain, when haram is everywhere, yet they turn away from the haram, brothers and sisters in the age 15 and 16, and they follow Islam. So it starts with yourself. No, the leaders, okay, the leaders are a mess. So what I'm going to do? I'm going to become like a mess with them? No, I have to teach myself, teach my wife, my children, teach my community, help my brothers and sisters here, they help me. That's how we build. But we don't want to admit that. We don't want to admit the uncle. These people, when we came to them, India, when a Muslim had authority, did you oppress them? No, we didn't oppress them. Subhanallah. You know, we look at Islamic civilization, the Jews and the Christians live in Andalusia, you know, in Spain. They will live in harmony, you know. They will live under justice. And until the Christians, when the Catholic came, Bob the liar and his followers came, start burning the Muslims alive and the Jewish people alive. The Christian families, they start helping the Muslim families because they said, when we live under you, you treat us nicely. But if people have no shyness, when we had a quwwah, a power and authority, we took care of them. We treat them nicely, you know, justly. But look, subhanallah, we in Islam, we're not even allowed to mock Moses or Jesus. You know, by this man who insulted Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's son is better than him. My uncle, Prophet Muhammad Alayhi Salatu Wasallam, he started by himself. He changed the whole world direction. This Hindu guy, he can't even change his underwear. He won't speak about Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So Alhamdulillah, you know what we have to do? Turn back to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala and expose them. Refute them with knowledge, speak with knowledge, you know. Alhamdulillah, that's what we need to do, uncle. Teach ourselves, learn our deen, Quran, the Sunnah, the way of the Sahaba, may Allah please them all. You know, you come in, look, like brother Sam mentioned good point. He said, they're coming here. He said, but why don't you protest against Britain who took all your wealth?
Allah Ta'ala changed the world, the just message from Sam. Allah Ta'ala changed.
That doesn't solve the problem because they are getting away with everything. Who? India, they're insulting the Rasul Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, making fun of Hazrat Aisha and those things, and we demonstrated because we have given the Dalil. That is the reason that refute. They say that Rasul Karim went on Miraj on a flying horse. They don't believe it. We said with the Dalil that, look, Diwali, you have a function. In Diwali, Rama story, that he married to Sita when she was 6 years old. Second thing, they have a enemy, Ravan, which has 10 heads. I said, how it is possible? You don't believe. So I gave them the Dalil. But
no, first anchor, Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, we don't have a proof that he flew on a horse. There's no proof of that.
Yeah,
but there's Adilla, but it's not clear. Rather, if you bring all the proofs together, the Prophet ﷺ went from Mecca to Jerusalem on the Buraq, but not from Jerusalem to Al-Heaven. You understand? So this is that some scholars said, no, it's not.
Yeah, that's the thing.
But even if you went through, Allah is able to do all things. That doesn't go against Allah's nature to Allah create an animal that can fly. Like, logically, how that it got against our human sound reasoning? You understand? It's like the Arab pagans. And now, imagine you go to the Arab pagans, they couldn't believe that you can travel from Mecca to Jerusalem in one night. But now we can do it. That's why one of the scholars mentioned, technology proves miracles. And technology exposes ignorance of the pagans and the polytheists and the atheists. Shows you that the intellect is like a baby. You know, baby inside his mother's womb, if you tell him there's people outside driving cars, have a phones, he think you're crazy, man. Because why? The baby to him, everything that exists is inside his mother's womb. You understand? Likewise, the atheists, because due to their lack of knowledge, lack of understanding, lack of intellect, they think whatever exists inside the creator, the universe, they're like a baby. You understand? Alhamdulillah. There's many ways, but alhamdulillah, we give da'wah. Uncle, alhamdulillah, we do da'wah in the outside Shever Bush Station, Central Line, every Friday. Wallahi, watch our channel. Do you ask da'wah, yeah? Every Friday. One, two, sometimes four. Wallahi, sometimes six people accept Islam. Every Friday. Every Friday we're there, either one or two. Less. So, alhamdulillah, by Allah's tawfiq. Not by my, by Allah's tawfiq. Why? And these people, when they see that, they want to distract us from that. Let us focus, expose their ignorance. What they have for Islam, Hinduism, what has for world, Hinduism? It's nothing, Hinduism. Hinduism is a philosophical ideology. They have nothing. Prophet Muhammad ﷺ came with the legislation. If the Western world, quote unquote, the civilized countries, if they follow Prophet Muhammad legislation, they will save their lives, their health, their wealth, their intellect, their families, if they follow that. Why I'm saying that? Islam came to preserve five things. And these five things, we do not preserve them, destroy societies. Alcohol, gambling, interest, usury, fornication, all of these vices destroy societies. This Hindu business, they have no solution for it.
But they are still prospering.
Well, how prospering, Akhi? Fir'aun was prospering. Who had the power? Fir'aun or Musa? Fir'aun.
Namrud,
barakallah. Namrud, that's what Allah said. Allah said when the messengers came to them, they become excited. The enemies of the messengers, they were excited with the knowledge that they have. So, this is Allah's sunnah. Allah's sunnah, the tyrants, they have dunya. But Allah show the mu'minun can have dunya too. However, where is Fir'aun? Fir'aun ذهب إلى مزبلة التاريخ. Haman ذهب إلى مزبلة التاريخ. Abu Jahl ذهب إلى مزبلة التاريخ. Those guys, Abu Lahab, and this Hindu guy doesn't make tawbah, يذهب إلى مزبلة التاريخ معهم كذلك. They will go to the bin of history. These guys, after 100,000 years or something, do you know whose name will be mentioned with respect and love and honor? Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu salam. Abu Jahl, where is Abu Jahl now? Who is his followers? You know, subhanAllah, Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu salam, one man. He came with the perfect way of life. The best civilization is Islamic civilization in the history. But the problem, we don't read. The camera is based upon whom? Ibn Haytham, rahimahullah. How many books were stolen from Andalusia and they ripped the paper and everything and they put their names? Ma'roof. This one known that they took our books, our sources, and they start attributing, ascribing this scientific discoveries to themselves when in reality the Muslims did it. One known. But we don't study. That's the mushkila. We're too busy talking about the rulers, Well, we don't want to study. Study, learn. Learn our deen. To build good society. Barakallahu feekum. So, la tahzan, uncle. Don't be sorrow. Don't have sorrow. Allah will aid us. It's not conditional, uncle. You or me, I have to see the victory of Islam. No. But let us be part of that. Let us be part of building that society, that foundation for the next generation, maybe 10 years later after, or 50 years, or 200 years to come. Allah mentioned, "Inna al-aqibata lil-muttaqin." The outcome is for the pious ones. No doubt about that. No doubt. Uncle, you're from India and Pakistan. The Tatar, Mongols, they were about to destroy Islamic civilization, all of it. What happened? They become Muslims and they start fighting for Islam. Allahu Akbar. Now, you know the Tatar's fitna? Ibn Athir, one of the historians of Islam, they told him to write a book about the Tatar because he lived that time. He said he thought it was the Ajuj and Ma'juj. He said, how can I write about the destruction of Islam and the Muslims? Ibn Athir, if he was alive, he doesn't know Islam is spreading in Europe, brother. Ibn Athir, in his time, maybe like you and us here today, thinking, look what's happened to Islam and the Muslim. You have these guys who shower with the poo and feces, insulting our Prophet Muhammad SAW. But don't worry. And someone said insult. That's the reality. I'm not insulting no one. That's what they do. They clean themselves with the feces of the cow, believing that it's a blessing. And they hate Islam because Islam says clean yourself. Alhamdulillah. That's why many times Hindu become Muslim, Sikh become Muslim. Alhamdulillah. So alhamdulillah, uncle. La tahzan, uncle. Allah will give us the victory. No doubt about that. But we have to start it. We have to fix ourselves. What the look, akhi? Hinduism, where is it? Nothing. Alhamdulillah. In Europe, akhwa. My brothers and sisters, in Europe. Europe, when there's many barriers, when the power is belong to the non-Muslims, to make Islam look bad, yet the fastest growing religion on the face of the Western world is Islam. That myself, you know, that increased my iman. I look at myself, I'm weak, Muslims are weak, you know, but yet Islam is spreading because Allah mentioned that in the Quran. Allah said, "Huwa alladhi arsala rasulahu bil huda wa din al haqq liyudhirahu ala ad-din kullihi walau kariha al kafirun." It's Allah who sent his messenger with Islam for Islam to overpower the other religions, even if the disbelievers dislike it. That's a reality. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Inna shani'aka huwa al-abtar." Your enemies will be cut off. Imam Ibn Qayyim, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, anyone that wages war against the messenger of Allah, except Allah will cut off him. Will cut him off. And Allah mentioned the other Quran, the other verse. وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. We raise your name high. Everywhere around the world, ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Alayhi salatu wasalam. That's why they're jealous. Let them die in their envy. But what we have to do, no violence, nothing, expose them. Of course, they should attack us, beat them up. You know, we have no violent business. You know, but try to stay away, get reasoning, expose them, show them Islam, how it makes sense. Alhamdulillah. Hinduism, akhi, miskin. I don't know who made it.
How many Muslims they have killed in India? They are asking every Muslim, call Jai Shri Ram, and they beat him. I have here the proof.
They're doing it today.
They are oppressing our brothers and sisters. Allah aid them, man.
Sorry?
I said they're oppressing our brothers and sisters.
Wallahi,
the Muslim leaders, they need to wake up and help the Muslims.
But
the mushkila, everyone's sleeping. All of us, that's the reality. We can't blame the leaders only, we blame everyone. That's our reality that we are too busy. Imagine a singer comes to Pakistan or comes to Algeria. You see how many people come to watch him. If you bring Sheikh Saleh Al-Fawzan, very few people in comparison to this singer. So don't blame we have to blame ourselves, that we have to admit, yes, we are married. What we need to do, next step, where is the cure? Not in the United Nations, not in the other nations. The cure, Quran was Sunnah. When you admit that, khalas, Allah, bi'idhnillah, Allah will give you victory. That's the reality. But we don't admit that. We don't pray. Brothers don't pray, sisters don't pray. You know? تكلم متى يا أخي؟ اسأل الله العفو والعافية. لكن كما قال المصطفى عليه الصلاة والسلام: لا تزال طائفة من أمتي ظاهرين على الحق لا يضرهم من خذلهم ولا من خالفهم حتى يأتي أمر الله وهم على ذلك. أو كما قال المصطفى عليه الصلاة والسلام: that there will be a group of my ummah manifesting upon the truth. They will not be harmed by those who oppose them or those who betray them until Allah's promise will come to pass. So Allah will give victory, inshallah.
You said that how many Muslims pray another thing? Pray, pray is between Allah and the person himself. But Islam not focuses on pray. It focuses on morality. That you pray 5 times a day, then you go and put water in the milk and sell it. There is no character in the Muslim ummah.
But uncle, if you don't pray, if you don't pray, this is no. Prayer is not just between me and Allah. Prayer, if I don't pray, I'm doing a greater sin. And that sin can affect the ummah too. And the proof for that, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, when he told the Sahaba on Uhud, he said, do not leave the mountain of Uhud. Regardless what happened, if we win or lose, don't leave. Because of the ishtihad, may Allah forgive them, they left. What happened? Nabi alayhi salam was injured, a lot of Sahaba were killed, they disobeyed one commandment. Look what Allah did to them. How many commandments of Allah and His Messenger we have disobeyed? The most important pillar after La ilaha illallah, the most important pillar after La ilaha illallah is the prayer. And we don't pray it. And we're talking about water and milk. The prayer that we don't pray, that is the most important pillar. If we don't pray that one, khalas. You know, rather, some scholars said you are a kafir if you don't pray. You know, why? Prayer, what it shows prayer? It shows the true meaning and the manifestation of La ilaha illallah in our limbs. Because the true humbleness and the true honor and true respect when you make sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the true arrogance when you do not pray.
Why you don't say that praying is important? Also, the morality, ethical is also important. So when you are say about pray, talk about the morality, ethical things, that's what the Muslims are doing.
No doubt about that, yeah. The other ones too. But what I'm saying, uncle, there is priorities. Priorities mean the most, the salat is between me and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give Allah's rights upon his earth. Allah put me here to worship him. So first, that we focus on this one first. After La ilaha illallah, tawheed, was following sunnah. And from Prophet Sallam. So if we say La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah and we don't pray, so basically you're not really true to your statement. So to be true to your statement, you have to do that. But that doesn't mean the other evil things is not evil. They're still evil. Yes, the heart, disrespecting the parents, cheating, lying, slandering, backbiting, all of that is haram. But there's priorities. It's like someone, he said, I'm good to my mother and my father, but he doesn't pray. That's good to be, but the prayer is worst of the sins.
80% people in After Pakistan, shirk. They do pray. 80% people in Pakistan, they do pray. But if you look at their character, you know, cheating, lying.
Sorry? He's Pakistani like you. Don't worry, uncle. He's Pakistani like you. Yeah. No. Uncle. Pakistan. Yeah, they do pray, but you misunderstand what I mean by pray. Pray doesn't mean Allah Akbar, Alhamdulillah, Allah Akbar, Allah, that's not pray. This is you moving. Prayer, when you pray, that's what Allah said, wa aqimu salat. Allah didn't say wa sallu, Allah said wa aqimu salat. What does it mean? Fulfill its obligation, its pillars. Understand, uncle? So, not just how many Muslims sit and praying? Allah Akbar, Subhanallah, Subhanallah Akbar, he's not praying, he's joking. There's no khushu. No, afwan. If you ask that person, akhi, what is arkan al-salat? No clue. If you ask about the football players' names and which shoes, their shoe size, he knows very well. So I'm not mocking those brothers because I was like that as well. No doubt. But we have to learn. It's not a problem that we don't know. It's a problem that when we're consistent upon our ignorance. That's the problem. I didn't know, and I still don't know. But the mushkila is when you choose to not learn, and that's why we have to go back to the ilm, to learn our deen, learn our go back to Quran, go back to Sunnah, study. How many uncle? Just say and speak his corner. Some people come, some Muslims come to waste time. I say, Akhi, why are you coming to speak to Hatun, hyena? This evil woman. You know, it's evil hyena. I don't know who's going to marry this woman. Next day will be his janaza. You know, this woman is an evil woman. This individual, how many Muslims go and speak to her? And in a time for Salat, few of us go pray. Majority is still talking, Muslims. Akhi Salat, I'm Junub. So what are you doing here if you're Junub? Go take shower, Akhi. Wallah, is you Junub doing da'wah? And may Allah forgive us and may Allah guide us. I'm not trying to belittle them, but I'm stating the reality. Uncle, may Allah bless you. Wallahu ta'ala, azu alam.